Strawberry Fields Forever Festival is just this welcome of those that have been called to this deep path to come together. And I always like it. We just seem to come in touch with people in such given ways and then invite them. And yeah, such a joy to meet them in the field. You know, that's part of the fun of why we put this on. Take the time to put it on because, you know, there's a welcoming. Welcome. And, you know, sometimes we hear their music or we have interaction like with Maddie Z or, you know, you and Ricky had a beautiful encounter with him. And yeah, it just warms the heart to think of some of the ones that are going to be coming and joining us there. Netta, Boa, and these different ones that have been called, and from our community. This is just such an opportunity to extend the gift that they have received and bless everyone and be blessed themselves. So, yeah, it's really precious.
It is. It is. It's like each of those musicians that you mentioned, they're all like deeply devoted to the course as their path as well. And just that, I mean, the devotion to the course, it's such a deep path of undoing the self-concept and being willing to let go of everything to serve, like to serve Christ and serve the Spirit. And so that's part of what I feel so honored to invite them and have them come and share their gifts, because I know what they've gone through. Even to be able, yes, to receive the music, yeah, they've gone through a lot of letting go and clearing their mind and devotion to the mind training. And so to have them come and share their experiences, and, you know, for most of them, their songs have come as an effect of the miracle, or as a desire for the miracle. Like, it's part of a prayer. Like, I need to feel your love, or help me release this, help me change my mind, guide me, show me. Or then the effect of going into a mystical experience. And so the songs we're going to be blessed with at the whole festival are that. They're purely experiential. All about the awakening, from the awakening, for the awakening.
Yeah.
And an invitation to be in it together.
Yeah.
And it's not a performance, like you said. It's like none of us are going there to perform for an external audience. It's the intention is to be in the presence and allow that to bless us and everyone at the same time. And and I feel that's what in some ways is probably different about this to most even concerts, where there's a real focus on the perfection of the form. And of course, we're going to have incredibly high quality because that supports, you know, the music. And we already have a team of volunteers, friends who are very specialized at working with sound. And so all of that's going to be there too. But at the end of the day, you know, if the sound, if the electricity went out, you know, we would all have the exact same experience, with or without the form of it.
Yeah.
You know, it's all about the presence and the fact that the Spirit wants it to happen, and it's the Spirit doing it all. And so nothing can actually stop that experience or interfere with it in any way.
Yeah, nothing can go wrong.
Right.
Really.